friends, this evening I would speak on biodiversity of banks of the Ganges. Ganges is one of the mightiest rivers of the world. It begins from the Himalayas through Kanprayag, Devprayag, Rishikesh, Haridwar. It comes to the plains from different parts of Uttar Pradesh, reaching the industrial city Kanpur. It goes to Bihar and then finally merges into Bay of Bengal. It is really very rich. If we talk about the biodiversity, it is really diverse. Different types of microscopic and macroscopic organisms, crustaceans, different types of animals, lizards, snails, mammals, reptiles, birds, and different types of plants, fungi, bacteria, and even bacteriophages. Different categories of plants, for example, cryptogames and phanerogames. Non-flowering plant, flowering plant. Among the cryptogames are bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperm, angiosperm, lichens, and different types of climatic conditions. Higher peaks, high reach to the Himalayas, are clad with snow. Once I had an opportunity to visit Manavilis and beyond that. There were only 5 trees of walnut that could be counted. There used to be a forest of betula, but now that has almost got extinct. There are different varieties of gymnosperms in the Himalayas. There are many gymnosperms, particularly Pinus, Abyss and Cedar, Devdar. Devdar has been described in the Guanche and some of the other Sanskrit writings of great Indian poet Kalidas. The goddess Parvati complained to Lord Shiva regarding the injuries caused by the wild elephants to the devdar sapling planted by her. Lord Shiva appointed a lion to guard the trees of devdar. This has been metamorphically described in the Guanche, and the flowering trees of Rod or Rod have been compared with a lion because of the fat skin of the lion. Really fascinating area, the biodiversity of plains of banks of the Ganges has well been described by J.D. Hooker in his Flora of Upper Gangetic Plain. And of course we cannot forget the contributions made by our sages in the form of Sanskrit scriptures, Ayurvedic scriptures, Charaka Sangita, Sushruta Sangita, Kashyap Sangita and Vedas. All the Vedas, Rig Ved, Sam Ved, Yajur Ved, Athar Ved, they have information regarding plant. Atharveda provides the maximum information regarding medicinal plants. In the same way, Sanghitas provide information, and Charak Sanghita particularly gives information regarding medicinal plants. So and so, there may be 36 synonyms of a single plant in Sanskrit and Charak Sanghita, and many of these are found at different places, different altitudes on the banks of Ganges. The Vedas describe Somlata. Three species of ephedra have been regarded to be the Som of the Vedas. These are Ephedra gerardiana, Ephedra foliata, and some other species of ephedra. Ephedra foliata is the only gymnosperm native to the dry and desert area of India and western plains of Punjab and Haryana. Formerly, ephedrine was obtained from ephedra, but nowadays synthetic ephedrine is obtained. Might have heard some of the medicines, cough syrups that uses ephedrine as one of the constituents. In the past, it came from plants. Taxus baccata nowadays has been proved to be anti-cancer. It grows in the Himalayas on the banks of the Ganges. Pinus, timber tree, Soria robusta, sal, the tree of sal that in Charak Sanghita has been named as Kaushik. It would be interesting how it was named as Kaushik. Maybe because Rishi Vishwamitra, which is also known as Kaushik, might have meditated under the huge Soria robusta trees, or because of some medicinal properties. It is known as because of its medicinal characteristics, Chitvirya. That is, probably some people may often take in the fun that Menaka was dancing while Vishwamitra was meditating. Perhaps some of them might have made a fun of that. But indeed, medicinal plant and its characteristics are valuable. It's a valuable timber tree and has been used from civilizations in making houses. Jatamasi is one of the medicinal plants that grows at about 10,000 feet at higher reaches in the Himalayas. Nidostachys jatamasi. It's purely indigenous in its name, and so that even the Western scholars has adopted the name, botanical name, Nidostachys jatamasi, because of the Sanskrit name. There are many names. For example, you see Badal. Badal is a relative of Katal. Katal, this is ficus-like, and it belongs to Moresi, and Badal. It has been named so because of the Sanskrit Lakuch. In Sanskrit it is known as Lakuch, and its botanical name therefore is Atrocarpus Lakucha. Large number of plants, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms and lichens, they are found decorating the banks of the Ganges. Not only this, large number of fungi also, large number of mushrooms, which are responsible for making ectomycorrhizal fungi of the tree, a topic of great importance nowadays because of its importance in biofertilizers. And many of the mushrooms may be of food value, some of them may be of medicinal value, certain other microscopic fungi, large fungi, for example, dead man's fingers, and some of the relatives of the dead man's fingers. Dead man's finger, the word dead man's finger has also been given to one of the orchids, and it was played by Shakespeare in his novels. It appears that the message of the Vedic scholars was read by the Shakespeare because they had described it in the Vedas and post-Vedic Sanskrit literature long back. It is said a copy of the, there are certain references in Arabic literature, a copy of Charak Sangita was sent to Baghdad for the treatment of the princess of Barmecide. From there, the literature went to China. Also, it is said that the Vedic information went to China through Jain scriptures, which are popularly known as triptych, and some of the Chinese scholars visited Nalanda. They also took the information. We have a very rich heritage. It is because of the that the observations were made by our sages on the banks of the Ganges, and some of the macroscopic fungi and some of the pteridophytes were described in Charak Sangita also. Hanspadi is a pteridophyte. Of course, probably that is the only pteridophyte that has been described in Charak Sangita. So, Hanspadi has been held to be of medical importance, and there are many trees, Tectona grandis, which is known as the glory of carpenter, Dalbergia siso, and many other trees, silver oak, and some trees, for example, Butia frondosa, which is formerly known as the fire of jungle. To say, Himalayas is full of plants, and particularly because of the moist conditions, availability of water, these are in abundance in Ganges. Mosses are also here. Mosses play a wonderful role, ecological role. They provide bed for germination, the seeds, some of the rarest of rare biotas like orchids. Orchids themselves are very wonderful plants. They are found on the banks of the Ganges. Of course, the maximum number of species of the orchids occur in the northeast part of the India. We are fortunate having two of the hotspots of biodiversity in our country. One of them is northeast India and second is the Silent Valley. I am fortunate that I have visited both the places. If you go to northeast, I remember I visited there in 1973, and after that the forests were so thick that one would have to use a torch to see the life at the floor of the forest. And indeed that was a treasure. The same way, the banks of the Ganges are full of living organisms. So and so that a large number of algae, blue-green algae, cyanobacteria, that nowadays has been reported to be as novel source of medicine. I think, finally, if you go through the parts of the, of course, at certain places, Ganges has got polluted and biodiversity has been greatly disturbed. Of course, it improves in while it passes from Bihar, it is better at Patna, and then onward again it is polluted, and even some of the pteridophytes as ferns, water ferns may be there under polluted conditions. Azolla, a water fern, can be used as biofertilizers because a photosynthetic bacterium grows here, and there are certain salvinia and other ferns also have been seen that can be used as compost. Thank you very much.